Guy Carumba. When the rising or setting moon looks a lot bigger than when it's overhead, it's easy to think the air is magnifying the image. But it's not. The big moon is just an illusion.
Find something you can hold at arm's length in the moon's direction so you can compare them side by side. It should be something of a fixed shape and size so you can use it again when the moon's in a different place. It doesn't matter where the moon is, what phase it's in, or if it's day or night. You'll see it's always almost exactly the same apparent size, even over the span of a month when the moon's distance changes a lot. You can take pictures of the moon in two or more positions. Be sure to use all the same settings so you get a fair comparison.
Biologists and psychologists haven't settled on an explanation for why the big moon illusion happens, but there are other situations in which our eyes don't size things up correctly. Now you know the air is not magnifying the image. It is having another effect, though. The moon on the horizon looks a little bit squished. Add to that the fact that it's a little farther away at that time, and the rising or setting moon should actually look about 2% smaller.
There's more. Earth's air bends the light path, so when you see the moon just coming above the horizon, you're seeing it over the Earth's curve. It hasn't really risen yet. Likewise, when you see the moon going below the horizon, it's already set.
Adding to the mystery about how our brains work, some people can make the moon illusion disappear just by looking at the moon upside down. Try it yourself. Lie down on a picnic table, tilt your head moonward, and see if that makes the moon back to its normal size. Or turn around, bend over, look at the moon with your head between your knees. Make sure you're with people you can trust, though, if you try that.
Sky Carumba!